It'll be hardly surprising to anyone who's gamed that much that another really scary series is the Silent Hill series, most notably Silent Hill 2. This is pretty much everyone's favorite game in the Silent Hill series, and it is also mine as well, and for good reason. This is another game where the character is a very tragic hero with a very interesting character arc, where you don't know much about him later at the beginning, but later on, as you learn more and more, you can see how his character is very tragic and pretty much irredeemable. Which is at the same time you feel for this guy, and at the same time you very much pity him, and yet you're very angry because he does make choices that are basically abominable and unthinkable, but at the same time you understand his human weakness. And this game does build a legitimate atmosphere of tension and dread, and you can easily see why this is a good game. I also very much liked Silent Hill 3, and I didn't like it at first because this game is comparatively much harder. And I was really frustrated by the game. I couldn't play it the same way I played Silent Hill 2, which I was able to kind of fight through without much difficulty. I think this game is much easier than number 3. And what I didn't understand at first was number 3, you really aren't meant to fight your way through much. In fact, you are supposed to run away from, I'd say, about 95% of the encounters. So you spend a lot of this Silent Hill 3 on your feet, just running your ass off, trying not to get eaten because the monsters are much, much harder. And in some cases, I think unkillable. I think some of the characters in the mall are if you can kill them, it takes a while, and I wouldn't even waste my time with it. I think I'd like to show you one clip in particular, if I can find it. I'm basically taking some of these clips from YouTube. Some of them I recorded myself. But the one moment that really sealed the deal for me in Silent Hill 3 was a moment where I think you're in a room with lots of mirrors on one wall. And if you've played it, you know this one already. You walk into the room and you can see your reflection in the mirror. And all of a sudden, your reflection stops as you're investigating the room and it just stands there. And you're looking around like, what the heck? My reflection just stopped. And the music kind of cuts out. I think you can kind of hear this low hum. And you're like, well, that's weird. And you try to leave and the door's locked. You can't get out. And all of a sudden, you can see this black, oily film start to fill the room and slowly creeps along the floor towards your reflection. But there's nothing going on in the room where you're at. And this noise starts to pick up and pick up and pick up. And you can see the oil creeping towards your reflection. The reflection's not moving. Oil starts to crawl up the reflection's legs. And you're like, what the fuck is going on? And like you can see like blood, I think, dripping from the ceiling and the walls and stuff like that. All of a sudden, the oil is covering your character's body. And you're like, what the fuck is going on? And the noise is getting unbearable, and all of a sudden you start taking damage, and you're like, it was really one of the creepiest, unsettling moments where you didn't know what was going on. You didn't know, like, if you were in danger, like, it was a very simple and well-developed scare that to this day is still very creepy. And that is, if you saw that one with the lights off, that one is burned into your mind. I loved that scare. And just check it out. It's pretty amazing. And it's probably going to lose something in translation to the internet, but this is the memory I have that abides of Silent Hill.